video, a fruit that lowers blood sugar levels, a high potassium food that's a must in stage 4 and 5 chronic kidney disease, and a veggie that's been used to get a stage 5 patient out of dialysis. Catherine here, I've been helping kidney disease sufferers to take control of their health for more than a decade now. And there is no doubt about it! The most powerful tool you can use to improve your kidney health is the food you eat. Even people already started on dialysis have been seeing improvements as soon as they started to eat the right foods. Yes, there is always hope. And this is one of the studies that prove that what I'm saying is true. You see, science tells us that as long as your kidneys can produce a little bit of output, you can still improve. Not just in stage 3 or 4, but even in stage 5. Unfortunately, this is cutting-edge research we're talking about. This study we just saw, in which the patient was able to stop his need for dialysis thanks to a better renal diet, was published just a few months ago. And the diet this patient is following to avoid dialysis contains some unconventional foods that we will see today. But don't be surprised if you don't know about these foods. Probably not even your doctor knows about these kidney-saving foods. Most doctors don't read this kind of research, and they are still telling their patients to avoid some of the healthiest foods out there, and they're basing their advice on old, outdated info. And obviously, the patient is the one that's going to suffer. Time to put an end to that. Today, I want to share with you 5 foods that are banned and forbidden by doctors. But that science tells us are actually safe and healthy for people with CKD. And we will also see what kind of food is the 81-year-old ex-dialysis patient eating to improve. But before that, let's start with a fruit that can literally lower blood sugar levels in those with diabetes. Yes, yes, it's incredible. And this is going to be a shock for some people. This fruit is often considered nature's candy. And yet, science says it will help lowering your blood sugar levels, not raising them. I'm talking about our first unfairly banned food for today. Dates. Yes, one of the sweetest fruits out there. And it actually helps with diabetes.
Wait, what?
But how is that even possible? You see, dates are so sweet, some people even use them as a sweetener. But they are very high in fiber, and these prevent the natural sugar they contain from entering the bloodstream too quickly. But it's not all. Dates are also a great source of antioxidant, and that's key for a better kidney health. Now the big question is, how can dates improve glycemic control if they are so sweet? Well, the secret here is the high phenolic acids and flavonoids content of these fruits. You see, the antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties these fruits possess have been shown to have significant benefits when it comes to managing blood sugar levels. This effect is so noticeable, even this study calls out doctors and tells them to stop restricting this food for diabetes patients. So yeah, can you imagine that? Scientists are actually publishing studies just to tell doctors to stop forbidding this super healthy fruit. And yet, for most doctors, it will take 20 years to follow this advice. So guys, if you want more people to know about this, consider giving this video a like and sharing it with a friend. Now, my advice here is to add this super sweet fruit to your diet in moderation. Do not eat dates only breakfast, for example. Instead, add 1 or 2 dates after a main meal for a taste of healthy sweetness. And guys, if you want to learn more about what the effect of adding more fruit to a diabetic dietary regimen may be, my video up here is for you. Number 4, okay, let's talk about one of the most dangerous lies out there. This is a serious problem still today for people with kidney disease. Many healthy superfoods were forbidden for all those years, and without any reason. Yes, I'm talking about potassium. Many kidney clinics are still giving out leaflets today, almost in 2024, telling kidney disease patients to avoid a long list of superfoods. And I bet that most of you guys know this list by heart. Potatoes, tomatoes, bananas, avocados, spinach, coconuts, and more! And this is a serious problem. We have seen here on the channel time and time again that when you start to eat more of these foods, your kidneys can improve! In this study, CKD patients, even in stage 4, were seen having a stabilization and even improvements in kidney function just by eating more fruit and vegetables, including high potassium food items. But why are some doctors still lying about potassium today then? Well, unfortunately for many doctors, that's a way to shift the blame and to cover their asses in case of a malpractice lawsuit. Because you see, a CKD patient can die if they have too high serum potassium levels. And the diet is the patient's fault, right? Nobody told you to eat that banana. However, today we know that bananas and potatoes do not cause high potassium levels. The cause is entirely your doctor's responsibility. Doctors should double check all the medications they give their patients, especially blood pressure medications, before reducing potassium intake, says current guideline for CKD. Because those medications cause hyperkalemia, not the food we eat. This is why most CKD patients today are supposed to eat more potatoes, tomatoes, bananas, avocados, spinach, coconut, and more. And now you may ask, are you sure that these foods won't skyrocket our potassium levels? Well, guys, truth is that while kidney disease patients used to follow diets based on limiting potassium for a long time, that approach never worked. It only made ending up in dialysis a faster process. In fact, if we take a look at the list of causes for hyperkalemia I just shown you, we can see that one of the most common causes of hyperkalemia is untreated metabolic acidosis. And you know what treats metabolic acidosis? Well, first of all, sodium bicarbonate, but also a diet rich in foods naturally containing potassium. Potassium is a base, a bit like sodium bicarbonate, and this is why potassium-rich foods are encouraged. They will actually help treat metabolic acidosis. It's not uncommon to see potassium levels in CKD patients decrease when they eat more spinach and kale. Next, number 3, some of the healthiest foods most CKD patients are still being lied about. I'm talking about cruciferous veggies such as kale, broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, and more. Now, these veggies are super healthy. They are not just a great source of fiber and many healthy nutrients. Cruciferous vegetables also contain compounds called glucosinolates that give these dark green plants their bitter flavor. Research shows glucosinolates have strong anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties, great to help the kidneys improve. Yes, these foods are especially healthy for people with CKD or diabetes. Now, the problem is that while these are some of the healthiest foods in existence, there are still experts recommending to avoid them. Okay, maybe these are not real doctors we're talking about, but you will find plenty of people on YouTube or Instagram telling kidney disease patients to avoid these super healthy veggies. And the reason is not potassium as some may think, but it's a compound with a super scary property, even scarier than potassium. I'm talking about oxalate. Yeah, the super evil plant compound oxalate. I'm just kidding. Plants can't be evil. But why are influencers so scared by oxalate then? Well, because some people are starting to call this compound an anti-nutrient. It binds to calcium in the intestine, decreasing calcium absorption. So are these Instagram experts right about oxalate? Should we all give up our kale and broccoli and start eat at McDonald's every day instead? Well, that's something I would strongly recommend against. First of all, because calling oxalate an anti-nutrient is not very scientific. Because this name can make oxalate sound scary and it can make people think that eating veggies is bad for them. When, in reality, the exact opposite is true. Now, here's the thing. While cruciferous vegetables are very good for you, especially if you have diabetes or CKD, what they never tell you is that even oxalate itself is healthy.
Wait, what?
How can oxalate possibly be healthy, you may ask? Well, because oxalate is not just an anti-nutrient. Like many other plant compounds present in cruciferous vegetables, oxalate actually has health benefits. Oxalate itself may be healthy for the gut and it reduces the inflammation. And well, some people are also worried that oxalate from foods may build up in the kidneys. Reality is that up to 90% of the oxalate found in urine is produced by the body rather than absorbed from food. So yeah, all that kale wasted for nothing. Now guys, while for most people the benefits of nutrient-dense high-oxalate foods far outweigh their risks, there are still people that may be sensitive to oxalate. Not everyone, just a small part of the population. This is especially those people that have a history of kidney stones. I would also recommend to be careful with high oxalate foods to those patients that have a fluid allowance. But also keep in mind that according to science, oxalate in the diet is not a problem. And there are things you can do to minimize the risk that don't involve giving up kale and other cruciferous veggies. My advice: whenever you eat foods such as spinach, rhubarb, beets, legumes and nuts, consider adding a source of calcium. Some foods naturally rich in calcium that are good for a renal diet include bok choy and broccoli. And if that's not enough, taking a calcium supplement or a TAM may also help. Now, if you know you have an oxalate sensitivity and you want to go more in depth about this issue, I have actually made a full video about oxalate. It's up here and also down in description. Don't go away yet! It's almost time to see what unconventional foods the stage 5 patient who avoided dialysis is eating. Before that, one of the most dangerous mistakes many doctors are making today. Let's take a look. Number 2 is banning herbal supplements. Okay, not technically a food, but still very relevant. This is one of the biggest mistakes many doctors still make today. You see, in my recent video, I shared a tea made with astragalus. Now, astragalus is one of the most scientifically sound herbal supplements for kidney health in existence. Astragalus is used on thousands and thousands of kidney disease patients every day and with success. And yet, I got this comment from one of you guys. Now, this is a very important concern because, yes, certain herbal supplements may present risks. This is why you should never take any supplement at all without getting informed about it. However, there is no reason why doctors should ban all herbal supplements without discrimination. What science says about astragalus in particular is that it works. It lowers creatinine levels. It lowers proteinuria significantly, as we can see here. And guys, this comes from the Cochrane Library, right? That's the gold standard, the number one most reputable source out there when it comes to medical science. And well, my point here is that doctors should get informed about these new studies being published today, especially if they come from sources as reputable as the Cochrane Library. Otherwise, all they will be able to tell their patient is, there is nothing we can do. So our number one for today. This is something I would like every single nephrologist out there to see. As I was showing you in the intro, in a recent case study, a patient was forced to stop dialysis even if he was suffering from end-stage renal disease with a GFR as low as 13. In order to avoid dialysis, he had to completely change his diet. The result, thanks to an improved diet, he was able to be dialysis-free for 3 years, the whole duration of the case study. And it's not just that. Even if he's almost 85 now, this man is still able to maintain his improved kidney function and to avoid ending up in dialysis again. So now you may ask, What is this man eating in order to stay stable in stage 4 CKD and avoid dialysis? Well, as we can see here, there are some unconventional foods this man is eating. And I want to focus on legumes here in particular because for many patients, legumes are completely banned. But are doctors right to ban legumes when there is a man that got out of dialysis when he started to eat stirring beans and chickpeas? Now guys, legumes are obviously just a part of the diet this man is following. That's a diet that completely avoids animal protein and more. And if you want to know more about this kidney-saving diet, my video up here is for you. And this is all for today. Thank you for watching. God bless you all. Bye.